In your chapter 16 Bushong book and chapter 17 Carlton Adler book, these texts discuss the pathology problem in terms of radiographic technique. We often need to alter our radiographic technique according to the pathology that our patients have. So as we go through each of the following chapters in our Bontrager text talking about the specific diseases, I'd like you to also refer to chapter 16 in your Bushong book and chapter 17 in your Carlton Adler book. And we'll go over now so that we can connect that to what we need to know to do to our technique each time with each condition.
There are two types of pathologies, additive and destructive. Additive means that the body tissue is increased in thickness or atomic number, and therefore it is going to absorb more x-rays and attenuate more, so that we have to increase our radiographic technique for these conditions. And then the opposite would be destructive condition, and that's when the body tissue decreases in thickness or decreases in effective atomic number. That means that it is going to absorb less of our x-ray beam, and we have to decrease our technique for that. Your text does give you some examples for those, and it talks about how much you need to decrease your technique. Now, I do understand that in the digital world that some of this is taken care of within the system. The algorithms will take care of it, but all of our KVP choices still stand even in digital. We should still select the KVP that's proper to penetrate the part and adjust the MAS to give us the overall proper exposure. So this means with destructive conditions such as emphysema, I don't want to use 120 KVP if that's the norm. I would rather go down to 100 KVP and make up for the MAS if possible. If you do use 120 kVp on an emphysema patient, you are over-penetrating the part. So keep in mind, some of those rules in film screen do apply in the digital world.
They do list a few of the additive and destructive conditions on table 16.4 in your chapter 16 Bushong book. And also chapter 17, table 17.2 in your Carlton Adler book. I urge you to go over those and kind of put them in your memory bank so at least you understand why each condition is in each column. Carlton Adler book goes into a little bit better detail, I would say, as far as the summary of the pathologic conditions. So you can refer to that a little bit more in that book versus your Bushong book. They do go into specific conditions of the chest and abdomen and so forth. And online there are images for you to look at in the PowerPoint and to review. There's a worksheet that goes along with this. So please complete and submit the worksheet. And always, if there's any questions, please contact me.